this tutorial, I'll be teaching you how to use the Context Action Service and the User Input Service in Roblox. These are two built-in Roblox services which can help the developer detect user input. So for example, when the mouse is moved or when a key is pressed. It's useful to note that both of these services only work when used in a local script. So for example, a local script in starter player scripts. I'm going to show you the user input service in this script. So first, we actually want to get the service and store it in a variable. Then, we need to create a function. I'm going to call this onInputBegin. Then we need to connect this function to the event that is called when the user makes an input. There are three input events in the user input service. Input began is what we will be using here, but input changed is particularly useful for calculating mouse movements. And input ended is especially useful for when the user releases a key. And then we need to connect the function to this, so put just onInputBegin in there. And there are two values that will be passed to the function by this connect. And that is the actual input object and a boolean value which tells you if this input has been processed by the game. So for example, if a button has been clicked. So I'm just going to call this process. As an example, in both of these services, I'm going to make it so when you press a key, the color of this part will change. I'm going to set this as green. It'll be switching between green and red. Now we want to see what the input actually is. We can do this by the properties of the input value. So if we're working with the keyboard and say I want to look for the key X pressed, I can do if input. Just for now, print x pressed. And as you can see, this works because x pressed is being printed out into the console. So now, what we can do is get a reference to the part. And then let's just change the part's color when x is pressed to, let's say, red. Then let's say if the input key code is z, then the color will change to green. Then let's say if the input key code is Z, we will change the color back to green. You might be thinking, is it not inefficient to do this local part assignment twice? But I'll explain that later after I do the context action service, because this is one of the disadvantages of the user input service. But if I press play now, X, red, Z, green. I can do this as many times as I want. So, this is one of the ways you can detect and handle user input in Roblox. When you have a grasp of it, it is usually quite easy, but it becomes a little bit more complicated with the context action service. Just like we do with the user input service, we need to get the context action service. We're going to do the exact same thing that we did in the user input service, but with the context action service. So, make this function, and I'm going to put change part color. And then this time, we have to have three parameters. Action name, input state, and input object. Let's first make it print hello world. Now, to have this print when we press a certain key, we're going to want to do this. Call a member function of the context action service called bind action. Now we're going to need to come up with a name for the action. I recommend this being a descriptive name instead of a name that tells you what is used to input. So for example, I could call it change part color. The second argument is the function that we want to bind to the action. So in this case, it is change part color again. The third one is whether you want to create something called a touch button for this action. This is useful for when you want to do something on mobile because it makes a GUI button that will trigger this action. In this case, we're going to want to put that to false because we don't want to create a mobile button at the moment. Now, this is the input that you want the action to be called by. You can do anything like what we'll be using in this case, key code. Or you can also do, and this is useful for mouse input, user input type, and then it could be mouse movement, touch, or keyboard. I'm going to do key code. It's also worth noting that you can put as many of these key codes or types as you want here. So I could also put the key code Z in this one. So if I press play now and press X, it should say hello world. You might notice that every time I press X, it's firing twice. And that's because, unlike in the user input service, where we connected it only when the input began, context action service is looking at every input containing the key code X. So that could be the input beginning or being released, ending. So if you want to make it so it only fires when it begins, we're going to have to do if input state equals equals enum, and user input state dot begin, and put hello world in here. The interesting thing with the context action service is that you can bind multiple different actions to the same function. So for example, I could bind another action. So for example, I could call this function change the part color to red when we press X, and then make another and bind the action change part color green and bind it to the same function, which is change part color. False, like we did for the last one, and have this with a different key code, which will be Z. So to check which one is being called, you can use the action name object with if statements. So if action name is change part color red, then, and we can do all of our changing the parts color logic in here. Else if action name is the other one, which is change the part color to green. Then we can do everything we want in there, so that is what I will do now. I'll just copy it from this. Unlike in the user input service, it is completely fine in the context action service to put the part outside of the if statements for each of the actions. This is because the use of the context action service is a little bit different to the user input service. This is because, as the name suggests, you can make this only run in certain contexts if you need it to. So for example, I'm going to make a system that lets you do this 10 times before it unbinds the actions, which means you won't be able to do any. Then for each of the actions, we're going to want to increment the count by one. And after this, if count is equal to 10, then, and then what we do here is get the context action service and call the member function unbind action. Copy and paste the action names of the actions that you want to unbind. And after 10 times now, the action will be unbound. So, as you can see now, unbinding the action, and when I press the keys, this doesn't work anymore. You can do the same thing with the user input service, but making the user input service only work in certain contexts is not what it's designed to do. That's what the context action service is designed to do. So as you can guess, the context action service is a lot better for this. But if you really wanted to, you can, and I'll do this to show you what makes the context action service better for this. So we can do the exact same thing and make a count variable. And then increment it every time an action happens. Make an if statement, which is if the count is smaller than 10. Then copy and paste all of your code into here. Now, these will do the same thing, but to show you how this is different, I'll say print hello world here. And then we'll do the same thing in the equivalent position for the context action service. We're going to test the user input service now. And every time that this is called, it's going to say hello world. But as you can see, even after no action is happening, it says hello world. This means all of this code is running every time we make an input. But if we now test the context action service, after the action is unbound, you can see that hello world is not printed anymore, which means that this code is not run. This means that in situation where you want to detect the user's input only in certain situations, the context action service is a much better fit. That's because, one, that's what it's designed to do, and two, it has better performance when you're doing this because it's not running that huge chunk of code. This runs that chunk of code even after nothing is being done. And even worse, this is on every single input begin, which means that even if you press a key that you have not specified you want to do anything with, or even click the mouse, you're going to have this run, which is not very good for performance, especially when the things that you want to do with the user input service get quite complicated. So I hope my explanations of the user input service and context action service have been helpful to you. I know, especially when you're starting your Roblox development career, these things can be very confusing. But once you have more practice and more experience, these things will become like a second nature to you. But even for me, these things aren't. Which is why I really recommend that you check out the Roblox creator documentation. This basically has everything you will need for making a Roblox game. Now obviously I try to make more simplified tutorials, but if you want to study something in depth, the Roblox creator documentation is there for you, and that is what you should use. The links to the code and to the creator documentation will be in the description. I really hope that this has helped you. If it has, leave a like, please subscribe, and also leave feedback in the comments on what you would want to see next.